Hello, and my name is Ashley Martineau from howtospinyarn.com, and this is a simple video for beginners to learn how to spin fine art yarns. I'll show you some examples of the art yarns I've spun fine using these techniques. This is yarn spun from an art bat by a classy squid fiber company called Parisian Confectionery. The little bumps that you see in there are cotton neps, which stay secure to the fiber. There's also bamboo and rayon and sparkle and wool. Really, really, really fun art bat to spin fine. This is another art bat by Classy Squid Fiber Company called Magnolia. And I designed this art bat with her after watching way too many episodes of Fixer Upper. It's almost all mohair with cotton neps and black flax and silk and some other pretty things in there, and that's a really, really fun spin for fine art yarns. So I'm just going to show you the drafting techniques that I use for spinning fine, and then you can play with the fibers in your sash and make your own fine art yarns. The ratio I'm using is medium, probably about 1 to 10 or 1 to 8. And we're going to start with some raw merino. This is very short staple length fiber, which I love spinning for fine art yarns. And the key when I'm doing a short forward drafting technique is just to have a small amount of fiber here in your drafting zone. Don't let the twist travel all the way back. Treadle nice and slow, nice slow ratio. Wait for enough twist to be in that fiber. And be okay with bits of texture and thick and thin. That's what makes hand spun yarn my favorite. I love spinning yarns where you can tell that they're handmade. If I want a perfect yarn, I'll buy it from someone else because I like it to look handmade. And the way you can tell if you have enough twist. So you can take some of the yarn out, double it on itself, let it twist on itself, and if it's nice and secure and it's not falling apart, you have enough twist in that yarn. That way your singles don't fall apart when you're plying. So as you're practicing, you can try adding a little bit of sparkle or spinning two different types of fiber at the same time. That's a fun art yarn technique. So I have some Angelina Sparkle going in with this merino. And this is just raw merino right off of a sheep. I picked this fleece up at my local Sheep and Wool Festival. Really short staple length, probably about an inch. And a lot of spinners go for merino that's 2.5 to 3 inches is what they recommend. I love a good short staple merino. It spins up just like cotton. Once you get comfortable with that short forward technique or whatever drafting technique that you prefer, it's just as easy as spinning any other staple length of fiber. So now we'll switch to a rolag. This is carbonized bamboo. And rolags are very, very easy to spin fine because they're already processed. They've already been kind of combed out so all the fibers in one direction. And I love that there's still a little bit of variance in the direction of the fiber, which gives it some grab and ease to spinning. Nice and fine. And again, I don't mind a little bit of variation in my yarns at all. I think that makes them fun to knit with and crochet with. I knit and crochet all my fine yarns on large needles anyway, so my gauge is usually very, very stretchy. So all those little bumps and variations in weight don't affect my finished garment. And we can add some sparkle to this rolag as well by spinning the Angelina and the bamboo at the same time. Just let the fibers catch on each other and don't worry about perfect consistency. The randomness gives these yarns a really beautiful organic look when they're being knit or crocheted, something that you definitely cannot get with commercial yarns. Okay, now let's switch to some silk. Silk is very easy to spin up fine using the same drafting techniques, that short forward that I love. Just be careful to put enough twist in it. So I think what I'm going to do is I'm going to bump my band down to the smallest whorl, so I get more twist in my yarn. And short backward is nice for silk. See how I'm keeping this hand still and just pulling the fibers back? Whoop. A little bit too thin. Now we get to play the game of find the end. Silk is a very slippery fiber to spin, so if you end up struggling with it breaking or falling apart, you can spin from the fold, which means you just loop the fiber over your finger and you bring a little bit out from that bump and spin from that, and that helps you hold on to the fiber and have a bit more control. And last but not least, an art bat, one of my favorite methods of fiber to spin. I have loved art bats from the very beginning, still love them. I love how you could give every spinner in the world the same art bat and it would always look different depending on who spun it. You can never spin an art bat the same way twice, and that amount of flexibility and creativity really is exciting to me. I'm getting back into my chunky game talking to you, so I'm gonna remember, draft little bits. Here we go. Nice, fine art bat. I'm trying to hold this where you can see it better. one of the reasons why I recorded all of my video series for how to spin yarn in bulky is because it's just so much easier to see the yarn when you're spinning it bulky. But I know the uses for bulky yarn are pretty limited. So this year I'm focusing on spinning fine and translating art yarn techniques into fine spinning techniques, which I'm really excited about. It's a whole new world of possibilities. I'm going to spin up the rest of this bat and change the camera angle so you can enjoy watching a better close-up view of the fiber as I finish this bobbin. But I hope you found this tutorial on spinning fine helpful. And for more lessons, you can go to my website, howtospinyarn.com. Thank you for watching.